On paper, chemistry looks like little C's and H's and O's, flat, simple. But just like a map versus a globe, that's just a representation. Not only are molecules three-dimensional, they can also be handed. Hey, handymen and handywomen, Trace here on DNews Today. Scientists find incredible things in space all the time. It's space, it's fantastic. But this find is a doozy. Using sensitive radio telescopes, astronomers found a complex organic molecule in interstellar space. The molecule is propylene oxide, and it was found in a star-forming region near the center of our Milky Way galaxy. But it gets better. This discovery might show that life on Earth is not as unique as we may have thought. Propylene oxide is what is known as a handed molecule. Handed in this case doesn't mean being left or right-handed like we're used to it meaning, but hands are a good way to illustrate what it does mean. Handed in this case means two molecules which are mirror images. They're similar, but flipped. They're asymmetrical. If you put your hands side by side, they mirror each other, but put one on top of the other, and you'll find that they aren't superimposable. And this is a super exciting find for scientists because molecules on Earth are just like this too. Let me explain. Handedness is a chemical property called chirality. And chirality matters because the building blocks of life are chiral. For example, DNA only twists in a right-handed screw and only uses right-handed molecules of the sugar ribose, but it also uses only left-handed amino acids. Basically, different parts of life evolve to favor one hand over another, and scientists have no idea why. Every living thing has somehow determined it will use one and only one of the chiral molecules available in nature, and even though they exist, they're super curious because chiral molecules have the same melting point, the same freezing point, and even produce the same spectra when they emit light. But even though they behave in the same way, they are not the same. Like a glove only fits one hand, molecules have to fit together in a very specific way. And for some reason, life evolved, so only certain hands fit with each other. It's confusing and crazy, but that's how nature works. Why? We don't know. A paper in Nature posits these asymmetrical molecules may have evolved because radioactive decay destroys left-handed molecules more quickly, leaving only right-handed ones. Scientists also know that molecules large enough to have an electrical charge will find their like type to bind with. If this was the case early in life's evolution, it could explain why DNA is mostly right-handed. But even those researchers say that we may never know. What we do know is this chirality is present on Earth and has been found in our solar system as well, on both meteorites and in comets. Of course, since we know life exists here, you know, we live here, it makes sense that we'd find chiral molecules here. Finding a chiral molecule in interstellar space, on the other hand, pun intended, means chirality didn't spring up on Earth. It makes it even more awesome, and that's exactly what the scientists found. So if these chiral molecules existed in the cloud of gas and dust that became our solar system, they could have reached Earth via a meteorite or comet, which could help explain how life first formed here. And finding chiral molecules in interstellar space, that has a similar implication. Because these molecules exist here, and now we know they exist out there, that could mean that organic molecules, as we know them, could come together on another planet, or perhaps they already have. As you may imagine, more research is needed. Because they can't tell handedness from this far away, scientists can't yet tell which handed version of propylene oxide they've found. Follow-up observations will use polarized light to see if one version of the molecule dominates the space. Let's give them a hand on that, huh? This isn't the only crazy thing found in space lately. Atomic oxygen was found on Mars, and it sounds like some kind of Simpsonian superhero, but it is not. Watch this video to find out what it is.
Well, oxygen is highly reactive, so it tends to bond to other molecules. So we breathe oxygen, we're actually breathing the most common form of oxygen, O2. But when oxygen atoms exist by themselves, chemists refer to it as atomic oxygen.
Does stuff like this blow your mind? It totally blew mine. If you have any other crazy science stuff you want to know more about, let us know in the comments. Please subscribe so you get more DNews every day, and thanks for tuning in.